Hello, and welcome back to some Mario Maker, where 10 Marios is not enough, so we're going to go ahead and head on over to the course world over here, and we're going to do 10 times as many Marios. That many. So we can do this on easy or normal. I'm not a baby, so let's do normal. And I'm sorry for implying that people are babies. They're not. Well, some people are babies. Babies are babies. But I like a little challenge in my games. So, let's do some normal. Oh no, Princess Peach is in trouble. Whoever would have guessed? Princess Peach has never been in trouble. So we've got 100 Marios for 16 user-made courses. Let's see how it goes. Okay. Gimmick Course by Kento. Okay, is the gimmick that these platforms all fall, so I have to jump from platform to platform to get through the course? Oh, and then gotta use a Koopa car to get through some saw blades. And looks like they put those there specifically so I couldn't keep the Koopa car. And they also put some blocks above so that I really couldn't keep it, so I have to get out of the Koopa car. And then I get to bounce on this Wiggler. Apparently gotta just bounce across here. And then they want me to fall on these donut lifts. And I guess then go in this door. And here we've got some springs on tracks. I can take a spring. Something tells me I will need to have taken that spring. Or not. I have no need for that one-up. I have 100 lives. Oop, that went the wrong way. Is it gonna come back? I don't know. I'll try going down, see if maybe it'll respawn. Boing. Boing. Nope, it's still very much gone. So, oops. Need to remember that if I want to just drop the spring, I gotta press down. Aha, I didn't need the thing. So, I can tell why this is called Gimmick Course. They just put in every gimmick they could think of. Oh, really? I swear, if one of these pipes sends me back to the start... play with those cheap cheeps. Oh, really? You're gonna do this to me? Okay. Still don't want to play with the cheap cheeps. Okay, so the correct answer was the first pipe, basically. And now we gotta go in a door. And then try the other door. And then we're here. There we go. And that is our ticket to the flagpole. Didn't bother to jump at the top because I don't need the one up. Yeah, this person really tried to put in as many gimmicks as they could. And since it was just gimmicks, not really gonna give it a star. It didn't cleverly use anything. Like, if there were hints on which pipe to take or which door to take, maybe. I'm hard to please. I don't star things without having, or without feeling like it deserves the star. Okay. I wonder why this stage is called, oops. I wonder why this stage is called Lots of Bad Guys. Could it perhaps be the number of bad guys? Clearly, Cam was having fun putting enemies in. Just wanted to see how many they could put, I'm sure. And here we go. Star ran out just in time for that to happen. I wonder if there's a secret down there, given that the spikes run out. Oh well, just gonna go. There aren't any more bad guys here. Wow, really? Well, this will be the time where we get through here. No. This course is not too hard by any stretch of the imagination. I just messed up the first two times, game. Okay. Did not jump in time. Got my rhythm wrong. Alright, so we're not gonna have 100 lives at the end of this, but we'll still be close to it. We'd certainly have 100 lives if they didn't cap us on how many lives we could take out of a stage. Alright, there we go. That is unkind. Seriously, it kind of bugs me when people don't let Mario go into the castle. Why would you do that to the poor guy? He's just trying to save Peach. Again, no star because just lots of enemies is not an interesting course concept. Widgehuggy. Oh, is that what we're doing here? Yep, that's what we're doing here. Oh, really? I went in the right door? That was not a stage. Like, seriously, that... Way to go, Bash, I guess. And what awaits us in stage four? So, the title of the stage translates to Beware of the Loop. So, I'm guessing... Yeah, that is gonna send us back to the start. Or at least some path that we could take will send us back to the start. And back to the start is not where we wish to go. So, let's try up. Nope. Okay, you wanted us to go down. Gee, thanks. This actually reminds me of some of those classic Mario levels where you had to take the right path or it would just repeat itself. Those were always my least favorite because there's nothing to indicate which path is the correct one. Let's try up again. No. Okay. Joy. You're wasting my time, because I couldn't guess what you were thinking. Truly, the best game wow, that was my own fault. Yeah, for all those aspiring game designers out there, guess what the oh, really? This is showing me the right way? Down, down, up, down? Okay. That makes sense. Uh-oh. So, down, down, up, down, up, I'm guessing. Considering a one-up is better than a coin. So it's not entirely guess what the designer is thinking. There is a hint. But it's not the greatest of hints. So down, down, up. Down. And up. Okay, if this takes me back to the start. Alright, it's one up, so going down there probably would have just taken me to the... right there, that pipe. Oh, hi! I don't want to get hit by your fire, Mr. Bowser. Really? You're not gonna give me anything to help me out here? Just gonna force me to... Nice try there, Bowser. So you want me to run under him as he jumps. No, he's doing that again. Keep jumping back, buddy. No, that's forward. I hate when people require you to run under him. Because if they don't give you a mushroom or anything, you just gotta... You gotta run under him and hope that you... Hope that you make it. And you won't make it unless either you start running before he jumps, or you already have a running start, so again, start running before he jumps. Though maybe he's squirreled away a mushroom somewhere. Let's go ahead and just take this path again. No mushroom there, no mushroom there. Why you do this to me, guy? Anything? I don't like running under Bowser. Especially not when I don't have a mushroom to help me make it. Like, if I had just run there instead of jumping, I might have done it. So, maybe this life I'll just try running straight at Bowser. Pray he jumps. I swear I need some pro Bowser strats. Just testing to make sure that the button I thought was the spin jump was in fact the spin jump. I don't need it here, but maybe in the future. So let's try just going this way. There might have been like a mushroom against that right wall or something. I know Nintendo likes to put mushrooms against right walls before final doorways and pipes. Didn't do the thing I said I was gonna do, and then killed myself because I'm an idiot. Like, honestly, if it was smaller Bowser, then I could at least jump over him, but since you made him a big Bowser, I have to jump under him. And he barely jumps high enough for that. Which I feel is poor design. Like, either give me a mushroom, or don't require me to jump or run under Bowser when the rest of the stage has no real threat to it. And I should have gone to the right there. Okay, there it is. There was a hidden thing. That makes things easier. Okay, I don't care that I lost that as long as I keep my... And I do it on the first try without hitting Bowser. I am truly just amazing at this, as you can tell. Alright. Let me on through. No star for you. It was nice once I discovered that there actually was a hint. But still not the most interesting concept. So, ghost ship. We've got cannons, we've got a pipe. We've got ghosts. Let's get them. Okay, I probably done goofed, yeah. Okay, so we gotta fall through ghosts. Ghosts we can't see coming. But we might do... Okay. We might do better this time. We'll have to see. Okay, yeah, we can just jump up between these guys. And then... Yeah, we're good. Really? Just that one extra step that I didn't even intend to take. Alright. Mushroom, get. Cannonballs, fired. Pipe taken while still having mushroom. We're in a good position here. go. And again, that just extra step that Mario took on his own. So that looks like somewhere that there's probably some sort of... Oh, is this what's going on? Need to wait for the bombs to kill these so that the cannon can do something to... Yeah, to push over the P-block, and then I carry the P-block. Not really a fan... Not really a fan of courses that force you to wait for things. Because sure, you can do cute stuff if you make people wait, but the fact that the waiting is forced, it just doesn't sit right. It's like, I could be doing something here, but you're making me wait so I can see this cute thing you thought to make it do. Oh. Thanks, camera, for not panning up in time. I'll just chill out here for a moment. Alrighty. And we're through. How much course is left? I don't like chain chomps, and I don't like cannons, apparently. So, gotta go back through there. It's fine. It's doable. That didn't even look like it touched me, but I guess hitboxes are boxes. And through we go. Okay, let's... That was unkind, to say the least. But this time we'll have our mushroom. Or not. Okay. Here we go. Mamma mia. And commence waiting. Yep. This sure is exciting gameplay, isn't it, guy? Oh, really? Well, I guess we gotta hurry back. Not a huge rush, but didn't mean for that to happen. Yeah, give me that mushroom. I want it. And since this is Mario Maker and you can't make a block contain a mushroom, but contain something better if the player already has a mushroom, I know that I missed out on nothing by not carrying my initial mushroom there. This time I'm not gonna stand under that, because I know it's there. Gonna wait for that, though I could have gone. And down we go. Now we've got a life, or rather a mushroom, to get through this bit. Still don't like chain chomps. Apparently still don't like cannonballs. Ooh, a fire flower. I'm sure that will come in handy during this. Oh, look, it's Bowser Jr. in a spot. And would you look at that, it played out exactly as it did in the 10 Mario Challenge. It's almost as though it's the standard. There's still more airship. Looks like going up is not correct because they got that mast in the way. Alright, we're done anyway. Not the most exciting level. It did play out kind of like an actual level. I'll give him props for that, but not a star. I give my stars to those who are deserving. Okay. This is an auto Mario. So, time to just watch the game play itself. Oh, was that wrong somehow? It is neat that I'm riding a Buzzy Beetle shell, but not a huge fan of auto Marios. It was easy. Yep, Auto Mario 2 by Masato. Alright, let's get an actual level in here, please. Oh, look, it's an Auto Mario. Oh, it's Mario Kart. This is exciting. Look at all that game I played. Wow, way to kill Mario at the end. Thanks for the one-ups, but not the most exciting experience I've ever had. Auto Mario by Gumi. Or rather, it's an Auto Mario by Gumi. Mega Lega by Dark Meat. If there is no Mega Man costume here, I will be upset. Okay, those are springs. That looks like it could be a Mega Man costume. No, that's a squid. And there's a one up. And there's me killing myself. Okay. So why is it Mega Lega when you have me be a squid and not, say, Mega Man? Oh, it's random? Oh, maybe it was originally Mega Man and then it's just randomized me into other things. Which means maybe that Auto Mario stage wasn't supposed to be Mario Kart. Lives. Almost got ourselves killed, too. Go ahead, take him out. For whatever reason, I hate paratroopas on stairs. They're like my arch nemesis. Okay, not the most exciting gameplay there, and I completely missed when trying to go back and see what was in here. I am good at wasting mushrooms the moment I get them. Okay. Let's see if we actually have a Mega Lega this time, instead of a Martha Lega.
Here I go.
Oh, we're Rosalina now. That's a fire flower. Fire flower is better than Rosalina. Like, in terms of utility, and also I'm stupid. In terms of utility, fire flower is better than Rosalina. In terms of character, I think Rosalina has the edge. Okay, now we're Robin. Go away. Thank you. Boop, 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 boop. Sure, I could have stomped the Koopa, but why? And that was just me being an idiot and jumping wrong. It happens. I'm sure you've seen it before. Like I said, my nemesis. I never get him right. Where did you come from, little friend? That didn't throw Koopas at me before. Where did they come from? Not wasting this mushroom this time. Well, I mean, they're just gonna give me the star. didn't have to go the lower way. I wonder. Okay, that's not a pipe you take. There might have been something down there and to the left, but I don't care. Okay. There's another stage down. But there's still plenty more to go. Next. I'm sure someone can give me a stage that interests me. Okay, that was too fast for me to read it properly. I may be able to read it, but not when it's that quick. Now, I always habitually carry many Koopa shells, I find, in case there comes a moment where they become necessary. Often they don't, and in... Okay, I wasn't thinking to read it there. Often in stages... I'll keep carrying them. Often they don't get used. And in the new Super Mario Bros. Style, the Koopas will eventually try and get out of their shells, even as you carry them. Which certainly causes some issues for me. Oh, there's a thing up there. Let's check it out. It probably won't be better than a propeller suit, but... Oh. Okay. I wonder if there'll be anything useful to... the star on. There sure is. I like how a Koopa shell took his place in the clown car. Come on, go up there. Alright, so you want me to jump on these paratroopers, I'm sure. And guess who forgot that you actually have to touch the ground in order to get back your spin. I'll give you a hint, it was me! It was me all along! Alright, that stage is done. Not awful. Not exciting. No true challenge to it. Okay. I'm not entirely sure what that translates to, though it does have Koopa at the end. So, something Koopa. Oh well. Hobatsuko Koopa. MarioWare, take a leap of faith. Oh, gee, I'll do it. Okay, you wanted me to actually go all the way. See, I had faith that you would put something below me. Shop troll. Well, I guess this counts as a level. Truly, just what an amazing concept, that one. Next. Come on, there's gotta be some good levels in here. Something worthy of a star. 65-1, run for it. So... Or maybe it was 65-1. Oh! Best costume! Let's go, Waluigi, we can do this! I'll just take the door. Oh, is that what we're doing? So, am I supposed to go in one of these pipes? How I feel too, Waluigi. Okay, so we're not supposed to go in that door. Maybe that pipe on the end is where we're supposed to go. Or maybe one of these has what I need. Or maybe nothing is anything. was not the correct answer. Maybe one of these pipes. Like that first one. Alright, let's go for it. They told me to run for it, I'm running for it. I'm running. Okay. They didn't say jump for it. Also, that felt like the tune ended abruptly. No! No! I'm not Waluigi. And I'm not Mega Man, even though he was in there too. Alright, come on. Oops. Almost. Not really an interesting mechanic here. Oh no, I lost Waluigi again. Okay, I'm keeping Mega Man. Though being a block would have also been kind of interesting. Alright, let's go for it. If I keep jumping. Okay, that little bit just there probably cost me too much time. I'm probably gonna die for it. Yep, there was no way I could have made it across because I lost too much time. Okay. Oh, how I wish that that wasn't the stage. Okay, I'm Waluigi. Keeping it. Okay. Not a fan of when it just plumps me down. Wastes my time. Oh! Yeah, the tune just abruptly ends. There's no audio cue for when it's gonna drop you. So you just have to know. This person made their stuff too long. Okay, can I be Mega Man? No, I can't. Mega Man wasn't even in there this time. So, maybe it is truly random. Okay, I can just run across those. Maybe that's what it needs me to do in order to make it in time. Okay, yeah. Just running. Super exciting gameplay here. Oh yeah, that's what I paid to get this game for. That right there. And thanks for making it so that you can't get the one up. I do like the Mario 64 you got a star thing at the end though. Sorry, Jordan, but that level was just... No. It's cute that you had all those transformation mushrooms. Okay, I don't know those kanji. Yeah, I don't know why I even tried to get the star. Bye, moles. Though with the star, I could have gotten some 1-ups. I guess that's why. That star is freaking out in there. Okay. Might not have come across on the capture, but that star was rapidly spasming. On my screen, at least. We're almost there. Last 4 stages. Goomba bowling. That's not how you spell Goomba. That's Goomba. Are these Goombas? Am I bowling for Goombas? Oh, gee, is it Koopa? Yeah, Koopa's gonna come down. Look at all this Goomba bowling. And they do force me to go down there. Unless I can jump over this. I cannot. So yes, Goomba bowling. Can you maybe kill these Goombas over here? Or do I have to jump on them? Okay, you can kill them. There we go. Yep, there's still more Goombas to kill. Oh, okay. I'm safe here. And we're done. No more Goomba bowling. And again, they don't let Mario into the castle. All that after a stage that basically played itself. Yet again, no stars for Lucas. Oh, well, he was German, so maybe Goomba is how they spell it there. Parallel worlds. Really? You're gonna give me a question block and not put anything in it? Why am I even holding this shell? I probably don't need it. Oh, it's a parallel world where everything's bigger. Is that it? Including Mario. Mario's bigger too. Oh, we're back. Right. I guess you want me to do that? Maybe there's a secret? Is there a secret? Oh, you know what? It's probably... Can probably use the big Koopa shell to bust the stuff. Let's give that a shot. Yep. Oops. Killed the question mark. That was probably gonna be something helpful. Okay, let's go to a parallel world where everything's smaller. Yeah, that's more manageable. Provided I don't mess it up like a complete and total idiot. Now you see, this is actually kind of neat. I like the concept behind it. It's a lot more interesting than anything that's come before it. Cause, okay, I'm just stupid there. Yeah, you go back and forth between a world where everything's normal-sized and where all the enemies are big. And you use that to your advantage to get through the situations that admittedly they put you in. And yet again, I have accidentally murdered the question mark block. Stop that shell so that we can at least get this mushroom. Oh yeah, this is a stage I can get behind. As long as they don't do anything completely garbage to me, then I would not mind giving this a star. Will the blocks have come back? No. So we gotta go back and get it right this time. Oh, you know what? There might have been a mushroom in the block on this side. But we'll see later. Okay, so here they want me to go to the world where everything's big, because big dry bones don't just die when you hop on them. And they clearly want me to ride this one. So if he would come back... Yeah, he just gets a little unhappy. Now they want me to have small thwomps, I'm sure. Yeah, small thwomps you can jump over. Yeah. Can't get to that. Yeah, this... Oh, I bet going in that pipe instead would have gotten me to that and probably given me a 1-up. Now that world, that map, that's worth a star. Good job, Brett. You've done an interesting concept. Tick-tock clock mission 1. How will they have recreated this Mario 64 thing? Okay, so this is a pendulum. Got a bunch of these little spinny blocks, I guess, to represent the spinning things in TikTok clock. Don't know what this little guy's meant to represent, but... Maybe just a regular Goomba. I don't know. Okay, that was my own fault. Oh, you know what? These are the blocks that rotate. That's what they are. Not sure what the spinies represent. Maybe they're meant to represent the conveyor belts? Though there actually are conveyor belts, so I don't know how that would be. I haven't played Mario 64 in too long. Yeah. These guys are definitely meant to represent the... the blocks that rotate. Okay. Let's get over those spinies. The thwomp represents the thwomp. Oh, I was right to hit that block. Now what do these represent? Are they the hands of the clock, maybe? Mr. Thwomp, you are too low here. And this is meant to be a hangy section from which you can drop. And there we go. Got the star. Kinda clever. It's cute that they gave me a star at the end and everything else was... it was all right. I'll give you a star. You didn't bore me completely. Made me have to think, and the cute touch at the end. That's worth a star. Alright, Kyler, let's see what your Chaos Castle has in store. So, we get to start with a mushroom. There's a buzzy beetle. Let's take him. No, let's ignore those hammer bros. I don't like hammer bros. Trade our buzzy beetle for a Koopa. Oh, really? You're the kind of person who puts Koopas in things? Barely managed to jump on that. Okay, here's the fire flower. That's the kind of... oh. Can't go in that pipe. Always gotta check, because you never know. So, I wanna probably get up onto that. Maybe just jump across, yeah. And we've got an incoming Bowser. Oh, with a Bowser Jr. on top. Sorry, guys. I see. Smaller Bowsers, you can jump over them. I like that. Gives you more options. So, that was a 100 Mario challenge. So that should unlock expert mode for me. That was my first time doing 100 Marios. Where's Peach? There she is. Hey, lady. Oh, am I? Gee. Okay. Is that it? Pretty sure that's it. Yeah, I know who designed the courses. We've got Kento, Cam, Bash, Roku, Dennis, Masuto, Gumi, Dark Meat, Tata, Shoptroll, Jordan, Runa, Lucas, Brett, DS, and Kyler. Such wonderful credits! So, there were two stages worth starring there. Oh yay, I unlocked Celeste. Now all the costumes I had before that were actually from Amiibos, so that's how I got those without doing 100 Mario challenges. And maybe next time we'll actually try an expert challenge. We'll have to see. See you then, friends. I'll probably also see you tomorrow for some more Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate Goodness. So I will also see you then, friends. See you then, friends.